In this class, we're going to study about parametric doors that will be useful in continuing the process of modeling digital mockups. Let's start the class and learn about these parametric door tools. Before modeling, we need to know the measurements which will be displayed on the floor plan. The width and thickness will be defined based on the following technique. Enable the wireframe view mode by pressing the F3 key. Then you can see the walls and the floor plan. Select the walls, access the segment mode on the command panel, and click Refine. This tool enables the creation of new segments, so it is possible to resize frames to fit the floor plan. See the new segments here? After designing the respective segments, let's start creating the doors. The height can be defined based on the wall height and afterwards easily resized. Let's learn about doors now. The selection box is at Create, Geometry tab, and Select Doors. There are three options. Pivot door to design a folding door. This is the most common one used here. The sliding door option enables the creation of sliding doors. This is not used very much in this design. And bifold door designs double folding doors. We define the creation method in the creation method options. Let's define the options as width, depth, and height. Which means first we define the width and then the depth and height. We're going to model most of the doors as shown here. See how to create the door height for this wall. Select the door and assess the height command and type 2.2m according to the original measurement in the design. Let's use the tape tool to check this. We can check which direction the door will open in the open field. If we need to change the direction, check the flip swing option, but we're not going to learn about this right now. See, when we insert the door, the wall system automatically decreases the door size. Then it is not necessary to use any other operation for trimming the size of the door. The only exception in inserting doors is for garage doors, which will be created following these procedures. First, look at the segments. Let's create this door in the garage door opening. Begin by creating a bifold door in the normal way. Start at the width, and then the depth, and finally the height. See how the opening does not fit the garage door opening correctly. So let's rotate this door and change the height, length, and depth values. See how the door now fits the garage more correctly. So in this class, we have learned how to apply parametric doors in 3ds Max. We will use them to create wall openings automatically. We can even animate the opening and closing to create animations more easily.